Hello, in this video we will see how to create such a pattern in Grasshopper and Rhino. This pattern is known as Erwin Hauer, the name of the founder of this 3D weaving pattern, and it's also have been used in different architectural applications in facades and other forms and surfaces. So let's start with it. In order to start, I prefer to create this pattern manually in Rhino. So this here is the body of the pattern, the base body, and this one is like the frame. It's also like included in the pattern. So both of them would be repeated many times to create our weave. So the perfect symmetrical would create a seamless pattern when we do the repetitions afterwards. So in the top view, as we see, it has this symmetric according to its x and y axes. So basically I'm taking the mesh inside Grasshopper. I'm just giving it like some color for this mesh and another color for the other mesh. With merging and joining, we are having it as one mesh, one body, and also like to make sure the join doesn't have any problems, I'm using the weaveboard join mesh component, which is giving me also like one mesh. So now this is what I did to the mesh. For the surface that I am using, I'm starting with some random set of points. I'm creating a nerves curve from these points, also like doing movement and rotation. So when I do the loft with the rotated curve, it creates me such this kind of free form. I can say it's like a base of the tower that we are working on also. So now I have my 3D shape as well as my base surface that I want my shape to be repeated around. I will do one process for the 3D shape by itself and another process for the surface itself in order to get the final result. The one process that I am doing for this mesh is I'm only taking its bounding box, the box that surrounds it at the maximum extents of the x, y, and z of this 3D shape. So now I have my shape and it's surrounding with this box. I am going to use this box as a reference to the morph process later. Also, for the surface, I'm creating a 2D domain that is dividing my surface into U's and V's as the value that I give. So these U's and V's will be the, as I can see, the divisions of horizontal and vertical as of the surface. And using this component, which is called surface box, so it's creating a box at each one of these divisions and giving them a thickness that I can also control. Now what left to do is the box morph component. This component take one geometry, which is my 3D shape, and it repeated from a reference box, which is the bounding box, into the targeted boxes, which is each one of these boxes. This way it gives me the repetition of this pattern, of this 3D shape that I created. And of course, if we do any kind of rotation, so the box points will still recognize each other and they all will move accordingly. This component now is giving me a lot of meshes, 192. Then I'm doing some like join, also like again the weaveboard join mesh to eliminate any problems that I can face. Then using weaveboard Catmull-Clark smoothing component, I am doing like I'm applying some smoothing to these edges. So my edges were a bit sharp, but this smoothing, the Catmull-Clark subdivision is creating subdivisions to smooth this mesh, especially at the joint of these meshes. Using another WeaveBird component, which gives a thickness, I am giving a thickness for like an offset for each one of these surfaces. I can also like control the thickness. And finally, one more subdivision component. We have this final smooth pattern that we aimed to do. So after baking it, we can see the final result just like this. If you are interested in this script file, please contact me. Hope you find this a useful application, and see you in the next one.